So here are all of my weights and accessories lined up for my training sessions. And prior to today, I put my shoe weights on these ASICS shoes, and those worked out fairly well as long as I'm not putting on any ankle weights to press down on them. So I've got about 5 pounds on each that I used on the shoe, but they would press on my toes. So after a while, they would really hurt my toenails. So today was an experiment where I put them on these Red Wing composite toe shoes. So they've got, it's not steel toe, it's composite, but it's still effectively the same as steel. So that no matter how many ankle weights I put on here, it doesn't hurt my toes. But the problem was that the ankle weights were in a different position. So that's why today, right up around here, right up above the shoe, I was getting some scars on my, well, you can see them right there. There's my scars from the higher position of my ankle weights. That's what I was fighting ever since about the third or fourth lap. Not very pretty. And a little bit spooky because it was all covered up. I didn't know how bad it was, but it was bad. So I'll have to put some bandages around that next time to overcome that, then I can position it. In fact, I did for my last couple of laps. So it's a learning process of how to balance these out. But these are, it's hard to get a lot of shoe weights more than 2.5 pounds on each foot. So this was kind of customized where I bought more ironware packets and then, as you can see, wrapped them with Velcro. So those are my shoe weights. They're 5 pounds on each shoe. And then around that, I put these 5 pound ankle weights that I can wrap around, and they're soft ironware weights around each ankle, these right here and right there. So one for each foot. And then around those, I wrap all pro iron weights, which are iron bars. And those are wide enough. They're actually designed for your thighs to go up around your upper calves or lower thighs. And I wrap those around the ironware weights. So there's one, there's another one. So that's another 5 pounds on each one. By the way, each of these have removable bars, as do the ironware weights. They have removable packets. So that adds an additional 10 pounds to each foot. So a total of 15 pounds on each foot. And then for my arms, I wear on my upper arms these All-Pro. They're very similar to these Power Leg All-Pros that have the additional 2 or 3 inches in between. But these, you can see, don't. They only have about an inch in between the packets. So I wear one of those on each upper forearm. And then on my lower forearm near my wrist, I wear these other ironware. They're basically the same as these blue ones, which have Reebok. I don't know if I can show it on here. Yeah, Reebok name on it. But it's basically made by ironware. These ones are black, and they're older than these ones. But those are basically the same. And I wrapped masking tape around them, not masking tape, duct tape, so that when I grab the railing, there's less wear and tear on the cloth that holds in the ironware packets. So that's 10 pounds for each arm. And then on my waist, I wear these clay packets, for lack of a better word. Each one's 2.5 pounds. So you can see I've got 4 of them for a total of 10 pounds. On a belt that was a little bit too long, but I didn't know what I was gonna do with it, but I found a purpose for it. I wrap those around the belt, around my waist, and it actually helps balance me quite a bit. So that's another 10 pounds on my waist. And then, oh, by the way, I wear this modified abdominal belt so that the belt with the weights doesn't cause any hernias around my abdomen. So that definitely helps, and helps keep the belt, because the obviously is heavy, and it keeps it off of my hip bones. And then finally, my 40-pound weight vest, again by ironware with individually removable packets. And that's the entire setup. Let me back off here again to show it all. So highly recommend ironware and All-Pro. The only thing I don't like about All-Pro is that they didn't do the Velcro very good on these. In fact, I can mention something about each of them. You can kind of see here, let me fold it over. There's a Velcro strip along here and strips along here. Well, if you just barely reach over to here, it's not a problem because the entire Velcro attaches just fine. But when you want to wear it tighter, the Velcro doesn't line up very well, and there's not much to grab onto. So it's unfortunate that they didn't extend the Velcro all the way down here so that when you want to use it in this position, you get good adhesion between the Velcro strips. So that's my one gripe about these guys. Also, I had to put more duct tape around it to keep it from falling apart in the middle and keep it from sticking. So that's like sort of multi-purpose. Same thing that I did here for the ironware. They have stitches right there on your shoulders, and I had to put some foam pad on that to keep my shoulders, reduce the bruising on my contusions on my shoulders. And that's one complaint about the ironware vest. And also on the ironware ankle wrist weights, I had to put a Velcro band all the way around, because you can kind of see over time this flimsy little thing that is the attachment for their Velcro, it kind of wears out. So I put, again, duct tape around this flimsy little thing to keep it together. Let me see if I can disassemble this just to show it, show what I did here. So again, it says Reebok, but it's actually made by Ironwear. I don't think Reebok sells this anymore. So this is their pad. So when you wrap it around, they have one adhesion here, but it's not very good, not very safe. It's kind of flimsy, it can break and fall off. So I wrapped around my own Velcro strip to get it really safely on there. In fact, even here now, it's sticking to my vest. It's hard to pull off. There we go. And so that gives me a really good safe assembly around my wrist or ankle so it doesn't fall off. So, but overall, Ironwear and Ulpro are excellent for these weights. They've done wonders for my training and my fitness level for staircase racing. Okay, good morning. It is 6:30 on Sunday, September 4th. Just woke up and I'm going to do a weigh-in just to see what my weight is to begin with before I start stuffing myself before the big crazy climb this morning. 100 pound weights as far as I can go, which I'm guessing is gonna be about half a mile. It should be that if it's a decent accomplishment. And I'm going to step on my scale and get a baseline reading, and then I'll start stuffing myself. So I have to put the camera down when I'm doing that because I hold on two hands onto this bar to make the electrical measurement pass from my hands all the way down to my feet. But you can see here I'm weighing in at 142.8, and I'll just go through all the other measurements that it does. This was 19.9 for the BMI body mass index, and 11.7 for the body fat, 11.7%, and 40.3% for the skeletal muscle, 1489 resting metabolism, and 3 for the visceral fat. The first thing I'm going to do is drink my special concoction that I made last night, one bottle of it. I got another bottle in the car ready to go just before the climb, but I'm going to start with 4 cookies, and I'm going to weigh those over here on my scale after I turn it on and zero it. There we go. So we'll see how much these weigh. Got 4 cookies because that's how many were left over at the from the catered lunch at the place where I work. So those are 5.75 ounces, and the beverage. First weigh a sample jar and zero the scale on that. And then I'll put the concoction in here. By the way, I've made a video of this called My Last Monster Espresso and Replacement. So this is my replacement. So I got almost 18 ounces, 17.75 ounces in my concoction, which is basically tea and heavy whipping cream, organic, and a lot of other stuff. One thing that I forgot to mention yesterday morning, that in addition to the unhealthy but yummy chocolate chip cookies that I ate, I also had my usual dried fruit snack, which is a sampling of the guys you see here, just a very small amount of each, but I'll just run through them real quick in alphabetical order.
They are Trader Joe's New Zealand sweet apple rings, Trader Joe's organic Turkish apricots, banana, organic apple cinnamon flavor, Trader Joe's dried bean cherries, Sprouts organic pitted dates, Nevada Naturals organic goji berries, Nevada Naturals organic golden berries, Trader Joe's organic dried mango, Nevada Naturals organic mulberry berries, Trader Joe's dried pineapple rings, Newman's own organic prunes, and Trader Joe's organic Thompson seedless raisins. So I take a small piece or one heaping teaspoon of each of these yummy fruits, dried fruits. None of them have any preservatives in them. And I wanted to just check the weight on them here. By the way, one other thing right here in the middle is my own concoction. Here's what's in my cocoa carb cubes, is what I call them. It's coconut oil, Trader Joe's organic virgin, steel cut organic oats, and red split lentils. Do not, I repeat, do not get the small whole green lentils because they contain stones. In fact, they even have a warning on the back here. It says, caution, may contain stones. And they do. And also takes a real long time for them to get soft. I basically have to cook those or put them in boiling water to get them soft. Even then, you still have the stones. Whereas the red split lentils, they do not need to be cooked. I actually just soak those in for about an hour in 100% cranberry juice, so I get the benefits of that. And also, I don't lose any of the minerals and nutrients by not cooking them. And to sweeten things up a little bit, I put in some Trader Joe's organic coconut sugar, just have a variety of sugar. So that's how I get all of my carbs, as many carbs as I can. And so I'm gonna turn on my scale, zero it, and dump everything onto the scale right there. Whoops, one more goji berry right there. And so that weighs 3.15 ounces. And so the other thing I do before putting on my 5-pound shoes, 10-pound shoes, 5-pound each, is I put bandages and tape around my ankle, Achilles tendon, where I know I would get abrasion or wear during the climb. So I first put on the Band-Aid and then to hold it on secure, because when I start sweating, it tends to come loose. I'll put on this tape and then I'll put on my socks. The shoe also has an extra padding on the back where my Achilles tendon would rub up against the back of the shoe. Okay, so I've got my shoes on. Again, 5 pounds each, 10 pounds total. Those got to stay on because they're too difficult to get on and off in the car. So I also, let's see. So I also put on my nasal strip, which will keep my nostrils open to get as much oxygen in as possible through my nose. And next I'm gonna do is soak down my shirt and put on my polar wrist strap and heart rate monitor and turn that on. Okay, so now I've got my thermal shirt on that will help buffer my 40-pound weight vest from my chest strap and my t-shirt. And I've also now going to synchronize my heart rate log with my altimeter by turning those on and pack the car and get ready to go. All set, ready to go. I have another video that shows the location, but basically I'm climbing 92 feet 6 inches each lap, taking the elevator down. So I'm shooting for 29 laps for a half a mile. I can't remember the best I did back in earlier this year. I think it was 20 laps. So I'm a bit short of that. I normally do 16 for a quarter mile. So here I am, all geared up. I'm gonna take the camera on my first lap with me, and I'm gonna do a quick weigh-in right now. I brought my scale. So there it is. Let me see if I can zoom in on it. There's zero, so I'm going to step on the scale, hoping I don't crack it. It's late. Here we go. 256 even. Very good.
Okay, just show a quick shot of my car here. Got my beverages ready to go in my bag there, banana, three honeys, my towel to wipe myself off with, two extra headbands, and I am all set. So I'm gonna take the camera on the first lap. See if I can show it. 1-0 something. And my chronometers, they're ready to go. Looks like the time is 8:12:30. Okay, so here I go. No more talking, gotta focus on breathing. So this is halfway point, 5.5. I'm gonna switch the camera over, look at the bottom now. Okay, forgot to show two when I started, but there we go. And that was about 4 minutes, just under, for one lap. I'm going to the elevator. And then I'll start recording again the last lap whenever I feel that I can't go on. The equipment fails or whatever. I hope I have a good morning. We'll see. I feel pretty good overall. Two, three, 6 inches each. That's the extra foot and a half. And I gotta click off my first lap. So it's upside down, but here it goes. One lap done. Thank you.
Oh, 15 laps done. Time is 85 minutes, ballpark. 3 minor wardrobe malfunctions on the 10th lap, was able to correct them. And I'm anxious to get back, so I just wanted to give a quick check-in and have a recording of my voice at this point. But it looks like, optimistically, I'm gonna make it, feeling okay. And stay happy, right? Okay, whew, there I am. Almost 3 hours later, 28 laps done, 29th lap done. In pain. Left ankle's really bad. Right hip bone's really bad. I'll be over pretty soon. See how fast we can do this. I'm gonna switch over halfway up. Actually, I should switch over now and turn it around. Oh, okay, I can't see it. But, just hold this up. Oh, by the way, here's 3. Oh, so that's right on 2. Forgot to show that first time up. Holding this camera hurts. My elbows. Watch. 9:05. Okay. Messed up my arms. My elbows hurt holding this. Gotta keep away from the lens. Sorry. Here we go. Past the half mile mark, but I'm on the last floor, 2 flights of stairs remaining. Here we go. Last one. Oh, it's off here. Right there. Stop this and turn it around. Here's my heart rate after a few seconds. Time. Absolute time. I think I'm just under 3 hours. We'll see. Time to click off the last lap from my clicker. See if I can get it here. This is, get my gloves out of the way. Stand by. Gotta see the 28 first. See it click over. Here we go. 28, 29. And we're on 11th floor. Nice. Okay. Whew. Mission accomplished. It hurts.
Yeah, buddy.
Okay. Going over to the scale for the official weigh-in. To show what I look like. There I am. So I got 15 pounds on each lower foot, 30 pounds total down there. I got little danglies, 4 2.5 pound danglies on each side, total of 10 pounds. They're actually dripping water right now because they've absorbed so much sweat. Got my 40 pound weight vest, and again here in my mirror you can kind of see 10 pounds on each wrist, 20 pounds there. So 40, 20, 30, 10, that's about 100. Let's see. So if I click on the scale, let it do its cal. Okay, there it is. Step on it. Just have to show how soaked my pants are here from the sweat. I'm just standing here and they're just dripping off. You can just squeeze it out. Look at that. That's just me squeezing the ends of my shorts here. Look at that. More. And then over here on this side, again, just grabbing it, squeezing it a little bit. Look at all that. All that that's coming out. So I gotta go change my shirt, but boy, this is the most soaked that my shorts have ever been. Look at that, still able to wring it out. And that's just like the end of it. For the final weigh-in, and I'm got my same cycling shorts on as before when I started this morning. And my hip, let me just look, I haven't looked at it yet. Yeah, so this is the hip bone bruise that I was complaining about because of my 10 pound weights that I dangle from my hip there. The belt was just rubbing up against there and that kind of hurt. Kick on my scale to calibrate it. And there it goes. So I gotta put the camera down to be able to hold on to this with my hands. Okay, so you can see from this morning, lost a few pounds. That's probably the most I've ever lost since I've been using this scale. So 137.6 compared to 142.8 earlier this morning. That is, if I can do arithmetic in my head, about 5 pounds, right? So that's just, even after all the cookies and all of the beverages, that is the weight change. And actually my spandex shorts that I'm wearing right now, my cycling shorts and underwear, are still totally soaked. So I've got extra sweat in there from the climb. But anyway, let's see, that's my BMI, 19.2. My body fat, 12.1%. It's about the same. And that varies because of the way the water balances out in my legs while I'm working out. So 39.3% muscle, skeletal muscle, 1441 for the resting metabolism, and 2 for the visceral fat. So that's on the borderline anyway. But the main thing was the weight. That's pretty cool. So I had told my sister that if I were to get down to under 140 pounds again, I would treat myself to this little cutie right here that I got at 99 cents only. It's only, let's see, what's the weight, official weight? 3.6 ounces. So it's not gonna take much effort to put this baby down. And this is my evil, self-indulgent, unhealthy treat for doing my 100 pound half vertical mile today.